Hi friends, I am Uday Sagar Kandpal and I welcome you back to yet another lecture on Java using NetBeans IDE. So the topic for today is to generate a random number in Java without using an inbuilt library. Before that, I would like to ask all my new viewers to please subscribe to my channel and to please like my video on YouTube, to please comment and share, and also press the bell icon for notifications. So let's start. We just need to create a function public double get random number. And so what we first do, we will first take a long start equal to system dot nano time, then while we'll copy this, so long start one, or we can say long temp equal to start, while start greater than 1000 start equal to start by 10, and we will divide it. Then for int I equals to 0, I smaller than, in fact we will do temp equal to temp by 10, not start equal to start by 10. So temp equal to temp by 10, and we will place a loop till temp and I plus plus. This is used to randomize the inner clock. It would depend on the clock of the CPU. Now the loop will be calculated depending upon the CPU speed. So we have randomized the CPU's randomized the system nano time using the CPU speed. Now we can do anything, like we can create a variable called temp1 equals to 0, and we can simply temp1 equal to temp1 into 2. So now these operation will take a particular amount of time. So now we need long end equal to system dot nano time and end minus start, end equals to end minus start. Now double random equals to end minus is equal to end, and while random greater than 1, in fact we can do mat.absolute because we will generate a positive random number, so we will generate this. And in fact we know that the end would always be greater than the start, so now we will just need to generate while random greater than 1 equals to 1 or greater than 1 itself, random equal to random by 10, and now we just need to return random. Now we have generated the function for get random number. Also we must change this condition to temp. Now long start equal to system dot nano time, long temp equal to start, temp 1 equal to 0, temp greater than 1000, then temp equal to temp by 10, then loop for temp 1, then end equal to system dot nano time, then end equal to end minus start, then double random equal to mat.avs end, then while random greater than 1, random equal to random by 10, and then return random. Now let's test this. So system dot out dot println get random number. Now we need to make this function static for that, and now get random number. So now we need to run this code. So I have run the code and it's printing 0.75. I again run it again, 0.78, 0.147, 0.9, 0.104, 0.93, 0.94, 0.128. So it's printing the numbers randomly. So it's a pseudo random number generator because it's not exactly random, but yes, it is equivalent to the function that can be used instead of the random.getRandom or the inbuilt function. So hope you like my video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.